On the Medical Watch tonight, understanding positivity rates.
Yeah, medical reporter Dana Baer breaks down the numbers for us.
To determine the threat of COVID-19 in each community, we need to look to individual hospitals and the metrics they use to staff and prepare for an overwhelming number of COVID-19 patients. So while the city and state disagree over computing positivity rates, tonight we look at how those rates are determined and why one may be more telling.
Today, we are seeing overall this week increased numbers of patients.
We've seen some increased emergency department visits. We've seen increased hospitalizations.
Our caseload has increased dramatically this month.
From the city to the north and west suburbs, the story is the same, suggesting the next pandemic wave is upon us.
Our positivity rate here is 16% this past week, which is a jump.
At North Shore University Health System, doctors calculate the positivity rate by dividing the number of patients with the disease compared to those symptomatic patients who were tested each day.
Overall, I would say the person positivity, when you're looking at a population, is the more accurate, yes.
Dr. Karen Call oversees testing at Evanston, Glenbrook, Highland Park, Skokie, and Swedish hospitals. She believes per-person testing metrics are more accurate. Those are the numbers used by the city of Chicago. But the state calculates positivity rates rolling over at least a week. In that time, some patients may undergo several tests, and each test is counted, not just each patient.
So if you're looking on a single day, the per-person and the per-test numbers should be very, very similar because we are not testing patients repeatedly in a single day. However, if you're rolling those numbers up over the course of the month, for example, you might have more patients who did get multiple tests.
Regardless of how positivity is determined,
we're still in a pandemic.
Rush University Medical Center pulmonary critical care physician Dr. Brian Stein says there are certain figures undeniably showing a surge right now.
And most importantly, is looking at the ER utilization, hospital utilization, and ICU utilization.
Patient loads are not at a panic level.
We are certainly not feeling overwhelmed at this time.
But admittedly, there is a lag from testing to hospitalization. More positive people today translates a week or so later to more hospital patients, then more in the intensive care.
Just this week, now we're getting 10 admissions a day, and we are on pace to have a record number of admissions per week since we started getting COVID patients in March.
More older patients are presenting with severe disease at Naperville's Edward Hospital. Dr. Jonathan Pinsky, Director of Infection Control, is seeing a renewed shift in patient age.
Over the summer, we saw an increase in younger patients that were positive. Now we're seeing a shift back to the older patients. A lot of the older patients had been in contact with other younger people who were infected too. Several nursing homes in the area that are having outbreaks of COVID. And that compromises about 40% of our admissions. And that gets back to the importance of following precautions, because what's happening is people in the community on the outside, when they go home, may be going to social gatherings and getting COVID and then bringing it back to those nursing homes.
So now it's back to the crisis plan.
You know, we have a pandemic playbook that we're going to use now that we created during the summer months in our lessons learned from the first round, and we're starting to mobilize those plans and see what we need to do because the numbers are growing.
Once again, every medical expert has stressed masks do help prevent the spread of disease, as does distance and frequent hand washing. In the frustration, they urge, don't get complacent. Back to you.